Coast to coast, direct from Austin. You're listening to the Alex Jones Broadcasting Network. Big Brother, mainstream media, government cover-ups. You want answers? Well, so does he. He's Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network. And now, live from Austin, Texas, Alex Jones.
My friends, I am totally wound up on this 10th day of July 2014 on this Thursday edition. Obama is in town. There are helicopters, army helicopters, black helicopters, police helicopters, Secret Service all over downtown. I was down there this morning. They were bugging their eyes out at people. Anthony Gucciardi lives downtown and had them bugging their eyes out at him just driving down the street. And I'm getting the point where if Secret Service says that to me, I'm just going to pull over, get a camera out and say, this isn't North Korea. You work for a total criminal who we wish no harm upon. The whole country's a giant fraud now. The borders are wide open. Big bank shipping the narcotics. Aren't you guys supposed to be looking for hookers and blow? They shut down all of I-35 northbound this morning, and I was watching it on the news. An hour after he'd driven by to some fundraiser from downtown, they still had it shut down. And I was driving to work and saw all the motorcycle cops still blocking the roads. Why not demolish the roads permanently? Why not nuke each city he visits as a sign of respect? As he gets off his helicopters and is saluted, a globalist publicly funding ISIS to carry out terror attacks. And he was at Robert Rodriguez, the Grand Dragon of Mecha La Raza's house last night, celebrating the destruction of America. Here's Leanne McAdoo's report.
Well, Obama is in the neighborhood this week, and rather than visit the border to witness firsthand the crisis that is largely brought on by his failed policies, he is going to be partying it up with people who have paid anywhere from $10,000 to $35,000 to bask in his presence at one of his Democratic fundraisers. Tonight, he is in Austin, Texas, visiting the home of Austin-based filmmaker Robert Rodriguez, whose ultra-violent Machete franchise is very pro-illegal immigration. But instead of portraying illegal immigration in a positive, good-for-the-economy sort of way, Rodriguez's film bolsters support by demonizing a Texas politician who's seeking to tighten border control, and also they portray a Minuteman-style American delighting in shooting a pregnant Mexican woman. So it's hard to tell if it's a pro-amnesty message or a La Raza cattle call.
We didn't cross the border! The border crossed us!
And of course, Jessica Alba is going to be one of the special guests at tonight's fundraiser. Now, Robert Rodriguez has done a lot for the Latino community. He's launched the careers of a lot of Latino actors, and as well as his movie Spy Kids, was one of the first theatrical franchises to feature a Latino family playing superheroes. They were the first Latinos featured in a heroic role, and Rodriguez did insist on that. Also, Rodriguez is a member of the National Council of La Raza. He's a president's council donor to La Raza, who, of course, promotes the race over everything else. And Rodriguez is one of the new minority owners of a television network. His El Rey network is geared towards a Hispanic audience, and he admits that his network, he will use it if the president or the White House calls upon him to use the network to reach out to the Latino voters. But of course, if the way Machete promotes illegal immigration is any indicator of how Robert Rodriguez is going to try and reach the Latino voters, well, I guess we can expect to see more messages promoting racial division rather than bringing us all together. So this is who Obama is spending his evening with tonight. Rather than visiting the border, rather than addressing the crisis and actually acknowledging that this is a huge issue and maybe just showing the American people, hey, I'm not afraid to go and be in these border facilities where there's all these contagious diseases running rampant. I mean, even that, to just go and show that. Nah, he's gonna go up with people who are paying $35,000 to go party it up at Robert Rodriguez's house, because he's showing you This is the kind of president he is, and this is where he stands on this issue of illegal immigration.
All right, folks, we'll be right back. That's from InfoWars Nightly News last night. Lord Obama is still in town. We'll be covering it. Stay with us.
Hi, I'm Dr. Edward Grew. It took me 20 years of searching the globe to find the deposit of the highest purity iodine available. The new Survival Shield X2 is mined from 7,000 to 10,000 feet below the earth in pristine, environmentally clean conditions. The iodine crystals we use are extracted from an ancient 300 million plus year old deposit deep in the earth. It's the strongest nascent iodine on the market today. It delivers 650 micrograms per drop. Experience the new formula. Experience the ancient purity. Shield your family. Survival Shield X2, available now at InfoWarsLife.com.
X2 from InfoWarsLife.com or call toll free 888-253-3139. I've always believed in nutrition and herbs. Super Male Vitality was developed to activate your body's own natural processes instead of using synthetic chemicals. Sourced from powerful organic herbs harvested around the planet and then concentrated for maximum potency.
I just received my Male Vitality about 3 days ago, and I must say, that is good stuff.
After consulting top doctors, nutritionists, pharmacists, and others, we have developed what I believe is the ultimate non-GMO organic Super Male Vitality formula. Super Male Vitality by InfoWars Life is so powerful that I only take half the recommended dose.
I jump out of bed ready to fight these criminals every day. I look forward to waking up and taking my Super Male Vitality and getting the day started.
It's not just the Super Male Vitality. All the products at InfoWarsLife.com are simply amazing. Visit InfoWarsLife.com today to secure your Super Male Vitality and other powerful products from InfoWars Life.
City of Austin tap water versus filtered City of Austin tap water.
I can like taste dirt in it.
God knows what's in this.
These people just sampled City of Austin tap water straight from the faucet. Next, we had them try a sample of tap water filtered with a ProPure G2.0 filtration system.
That one is better.
Tastes like nothing.
Yep, I know what good water tastes like. It's good water.
Most tap water contains added substances like fluoride, chlorine, glyphosate, and many others. Studies prove that these substances are linked to an assortment of major health issues, including tooth decay, lowered IQ, and even cancer.
It tastes like you're drinking out of the lake when you're drinking tap water.
The ProPure G2.0 filtration system removes these deadly substances, leaving only fresh-tasting, deliciously clean water.
Okay, this is very tasty.
It's good water.
Refreshing.
It's good.
Go to InfoWarsStore.com today. Use promo code WATER and save 10% off your ProPure purchase. Or call 1-888-253-3139.
Rallying patriots worldwide in defense of human liberty. It's Alex Jones.
Generals gathered in their masses, just like witches at black masses.
In the fields, the bodies burning.
Evil minds that plot destruction.
Sorcerers of death's construction.
Construction.
And over in the Middle East right now, the ISIS New World Order Force is engaged in massive destruction of Christian churches, minority Muslim mosque, and engaged in mass exterminations. We're now several months into that, 3+ years into 300 plus thousand murdered at the hands of Al-Qaeda and ISIS forces in Syria. And Defense Secretary Hagel has come out saying every country in the world is threatened by ISIS. Basically, give up all your rights or they'll kill you any minute. When he literally is overseeing the transference of weapons to them. And they are a Saudi Arabian army. Simply amazing. And that's even in major defense publications. That's not even hidden or debated at an academic or military level. The general public, though, is being told, we're going to take all your rights because of ISIS. when it's publicly run by the criminals that sit upon our government. I'm going to get into Barack Obama and the fact that he's spending 3 days in Austin, three hellish days, I guess staying down at the W Hotel, with Secret Service crawling all over downtown, literally bugging their eyes out hatefully at men, women, and children to let you know you are scum, you are a slave. It's not about keeping the criminal puppet Obama safe. It's all about dominating America. Helicopters, checkpoints, I-35, the most busy highway in the country, the most busy stretch is through Austin. That's on record, according to the National Transportation Bureau. And openly, ladies and gentlemen, I-35 shut down for hours, southbound today. And even after 45 minutes after Obama had left, I was watching the news. I said, I'll drive into the office now. I have to go down I-35 partway. I'm driving, and he's been gone for 45 minutes to an hour, and there's still the highway shut with more Austin police cars driving around. And the headline is from KVUE, Obama visit costs APD thousands. How about hundreds of thousands? And I mean, I think I want to go find some Secret Service downtown and just go up to them and say, why are you in make-believe land bugging your eyes out at, like, families pushing baby strollers who don't even care that Obama's here? We're here working and living, and then every time the emperor shows up, he could easily fly helicopters to nearby fields like he does in D.C. and places they won't put up with it, and then get in a limo and drive a mile to these fundraisers with all these different Democratic mafia bosses in Austin who've already destroyed California and now moved here. Instead, they just want to shut everything down. It really makes me want to throw up. And I've talked to multiple people that have been downtown who are just blocks and blocks away from where Obama is at, with the Secret Service just rolling around bugging their eyes out of people. And I've had the Secret Service, and I've told this story many times, at Bilderberg 2008. No one knew where Hillary and Obama were in Virginia. They disappeared for over a day. We were there. The armored limousines came in with Hillary and Obama. It later came out they were there years later. And they would actually lift HK MP5s up and point them in our direction as we stood there with video cameras or with bullhorns. Like, ooh, I'm intimidating you because you're out here reporting. As if that scares me. If I want to go buy a dark suit and wear sunglasses, I can do it all day long. And I'd watch Secret Service walk around with their little, you know, their little jackets, talking into it like they're imagining they're in movies. I mean, what a joke. You're not Clint Eastwood, okay? And again, I shouldn't even attack the Secret Service. I know a lot of them, and I know some very close to the criminal operation, and they say it's worse than we know. Not just Bongino on the air, it was a senior Secret Service, but a lot of them. But I think it's the mid and low level ones that they have out far off that are just trying to play the part of a movie or something. And, you know, I don't like going to really bad third world countries because the police act a little like that. And I've been in England when the prime minister's right down the street and their people don't act like that. I've been there when royalty's running around and they don't act like that. I mean, this is the new royalty. And Edward Bernays, the big psych warfare chief, Sigmund Freud's nephew, who worked for the Department of War, the Department of Defense, the greatest PR propaganda master probably of all time, except for Joseph Goebbels, maybe. Joseph Goebbels was so jealous of him, it came out in the Nazi files. They had an international hit out of $1 million on Edward Bernays. That's how jealous they were of him. But he was just as bad in many respects as the Nazis. And, of course, he wrote three books bragging about how he mind-controlled the public for the globalist. And Bernays got into the fact in the 20s, and he worked right up into the 70s when he was like 90-something years old, that we've got to merge politics with Hollywood that was starting to burgeon at the time and just make it all about how they're the new royalty, so it's not about their policies, and so the public feel removed from the political elite and feel powerless. And that's what the helicopters and the checkpoints and the TSA and the red carpets and the Air Force One and the Hollywood dinners with Obama is all about, is to make you think they're prestigious and, oh my gosh, like Hollywood people. And then the political class grovels to Hollywood stars, and the Hollywood stars then grovel to the